Hi, good day. My name is Masi Ambibaling from BSN2 Widenbeck. So for today's video, I'm going to perform the eye installation. But first, I'm going to tell you what is eye installation. Eye installation is the administration of the medication to the eye. There are three objectives of eye installation. Number one, to directly apply the medications into the eye. Number two, to provide means for eye evaluation. And number three, to obtain desired therapeutic effect. Now, let us proceed to the procedure.
Step number one, gather equipment and check medication order against the original physician's order according to agency policy. Clarify any inconsistencies and check the patient's chart for allergies. This comparison helps to identify errors that may have occurred when orders were transcribed. The physician's order is the legal record of medication orders for each agency. Step number two. Know the actions, special nursing considerations, safe dose ranges, purpose of administration, and adverse effects of the medication to be administered. Consider the appropriateness of the medication for this patient. This knowledge aids the nurse in evaluating the therapeutic effect of the medication in relation to the patient's disorder and can also be used to educate the patient about the medication. Step number three, perform hand hygiene. Performing hand hygiene prevents the spread of microorganisms. Step number four, place medication on a tray or move the medication cart outside of the patient's room or prepare for administration in the medication area. Organization facilitates error-free administration and saves time. Step number 5. Transport medications to the patient's bedside carefully and keep the medications inside at all times. Careful handling and close observation prevent accidental or deliberate disarrangement of medications. Step number 6. Identify the patient by checking the name and identification on the patient's identification band or ask the patient to state his or her name. Identifying the patient ensures the right patient receives the medication and helps prevent errors. Step number 7. Explain the procedure to the patient. Explaining the procedure to the patient gains cooperation and allies anxiety. Step number 8. Offer tissue to the patient. Solution and tears may spill from the eye during the procedure. Step number 9 is to cleanse the eyelids and eyelashes of any drainage with a washcloth, cotton balls, or gauze moistened with normal saline solution. Use each area of the cleaning surface once, moving from the inner toward the outer canthus. Debris can be carried into the eye when the conjunctival sac is exposed. Using each area of the gauze once and moving from the inner canthus to the outer canthus prevents carrying debris to the lacrimal ducts. Step number 10. Tilt the patient's head back slightly if sitting or place the patient's head over a pillow if lying down. The head may be turned slightly to the affected side to prevent solution or tears from flowing toward the opposite eye. Tilting the patient's head back slightly makes it easier to reach the conjunctival sac and this should be avoided if the patient has a cervical spine injury. Step number 11. Remove cap from medication bottle. Being careful to not to touch the inner side of the cup. Touching the inner side of the cup may contaminate the bottle of medication. Step number 12. Invert the monodrip that is commonly used to instill eye drops. Have patient look up and focus on something on the ceiling. By having the patient look up, the procedure is less traumatic and keeps the eye instilled. Step number 13. Place thumb or two fingers near margin of lower eyelid immediately below eyelashes and exert pressure downward over bony prominence of cheek. Lower conjunctival sac is exposed as lower lid is pulled down. The eye drop should be placed in the conjunctival sac and not directly on the eyeball. Hold dropper close to eye but avoid touching eyelids or lashes. Squeeze container and allow prescribed number of drops to fall in lower conjunctival sac. Touching the eye, eyelids, or lashes can contaminate the medication in the bottle, startle the patient, causing blinking, or injure the eye. Do not allow medication to fall into cornea. This may injure cornea or cause the patient to have an unpleasant sensation. Release lower lid after eye drops are instilled. Ask the patient to close eyes gently. This allows the medication to be distributed of the entire eye. Instruct the patient not to rub affected eye, and this prevents injury and irritation to the eye. Third, that perform hand hygiene, because hand hygiene deters the spread of microorganisms. After that, assist patient to a comfortable position because this ensures patient's comfort. For the evaluation, number 1, patient cooperates with instillation of eye medication. Number 2, desired therapeutic effect is obtained. And number 3, experiences no adverse effects including allergy response, systemic effect, or injury.